Hey, YouTube. Feels like deja vu. Moving people and goods into the island. We did it. Seriously though, I haven't made a functional city for years as I've been preoccupied with building Hoopajoops. Yet, happily, I nevertheless found the inspiration for my first delve into eccentric roads for this series, an introduction to the matrix of heedless enormity to come. Or so I hope. Make city building functional again. A pleasant regime so far. Building the pier. Rail is introduced to the island, woohoo, more infrastructure. Sandwiched between the placemark elevated dirt roads from last time, serving as the cargo dock's sole means of connectivity. The roads being declined and solely servicing a ferry stop. The placement of which coincides with the termination of the dock, or rather the extended dock, as the protruding U-turn rail connection is surrounded by quays platformed with pedestrian roads. A road penetrates the quay, made to be a ground road, to afford hidden access to the ferry pier that permits tenacity of the wooden veneer native to the link-lacking elevated dirt road, and the fact of rail-only dock connection isn't quite so, as said road extends to allow access of compulsory services, though truck access is banned. Neighbouring replication is prompted by a fortuitousness of ground road connection, being the cessation of guardrails that otherwise obstruct the platform, a trade-off being gravel-textured corners. You can't have everything. Pedestrian roads flatten terrain jutting around the edges, aka Babby terraforming network. Did someone say Pipe Tycoon? No, this isn't Pipe Tycoon. Granted, it is similar to Pipe Tycoon. Like my previous wharf, this seaward projection carries conveyors, formed by cubic container segments and supported by rail pillars, rail ironically admitted underneath. Unlike my previous wharf, I classify this seaward projection as a pier. Apparently inhabitants of the inspiring town are the subject of decades-long deception. Auspiciously, prior this enlightenment, my interpretation of a pier idiomatically hinged on increased support density, which these wooden pillars achieve. The pillars decline with the road grade but persist under the rail, looking nice and blocky, and even under the curved section, basically Roller Coaster Tycoon. At this point, the pier was finished, but I later decide to add more dock/cranes by tacking on the small harbour, making the distance between the shore and dock appear too short, so I insert more transit decking. Building the cargo facility. A battery of large grain silos is duplicated and raised, reversing the end segments so the attached shed is hidden. The foundations of the silos, summoning concrete cylinders exactly the size and shape of the silo body as they are raised, are visible, about which there is little I can do, except offset the top layer slightly so at least one side is unaffected. Another battery is formed with industrial sheds and placed on top. More batteries? More sheds. It's a generic processing shed. And two of these buildings are clipped, tall and bulky enough to appropriate conveyor anchorage. Road meets the land, turning to border the coast-adjacent plateau, and the median is maintained, now empty, as rail turns to border the swamp-adjacent plateau. Unbound from roads, rail immediately branches to spawn a cargo station, filling the resulting gap with singular rail yard fodder. Said fodder extending for some time as swamp adjacency persists, though plateau status requires restoration, pivotal to the Fugazi that this location would naturally be chosen for a rail yard as, conveniently, it required no ponderous excavation. The processing shed is positioned along the tracks behind the cargo station, and the silos slightly distend the shore, bolstered by Babby terraforming network, which sets the slope for retaining rocks. How to link silos with conveyors? More shedware. Again tall and bulky, forming a discrete right angle for the conveyor path when clipped together. Holy Timbuktu. These old-timey pillars are the gift that keeps on giving. That's an awful lot of silos for such a small region, but not when I turn most of them off, it's not. although turning them off doesn't seem to prevent employment like I hoped, so I employ Rico to diminish the work account for small town stats. You can click on the building to change settings now, and they change instantly. Beautiful Janus! A hidden barn supplants the storage function lost due to conversion. Road time. Wouldn't it be cool if that became a catchphrase? No, it wouldn't. Yes, it would. No. But maybe. The manual median road leads to a dead end for now, which will serve in future as one entry to the port for traffic coming from this general direction, while existing highway serves our established municipalities. Established visitors turn onto the median road for ferry access, though cargo takes a detour to the pier by way of rail first, recalling lack of dock road access. This means all cargo traffic is destined for the cargo station, so a roundabout eases the course of traffic destined for this road, which I figure will lead somewhere, or harbour industry that is, significant. As general direction traffic will crowd the median road, there is a separate entry for established station-bound traffic. But where will they exit? Naturally, traffic flows straight through at the roundabout, however a contralane is employed for some distance to avoid intersecting concavely. A wonderful excuse for extra lanes slash complexity. The Flora's future seems nefarious. Drained of mystery. Known in my bones. Actually, it turns out pretty dope. Check dem rollin' marshmallow hills. This swanky little shed at the end. Fences. What's this? Looks like garbage. Actually, it's a pariah of essential services that I hope will help with the ship-only island access. Most notably the ferry stop, which sneakily, somewhat, establishes an outside road connection to the island. Actual garbage coming next episode. For now, population lurches from trash build-up, but alright, nice to see you everyone. Hey, hi, welcome to the island. How is the ferry? A secret pariah at the outskirts of town? Sorry, don't know what you're talking about. This facility sirens the call to fill the island with farms and will service all industry slash cargo until an upgrade or second port is required. When it comes to future farms slash population, that median road means business. And I, for one, welcome our new roundabout overlords. Rail. How easy would it be to extend this line? Very easy. That's how. Easy. That's all. Thanks for watching and goodbye forever. Let's be funky. Let's be fun. Let's paint the conveyors red.